Hi friends, today we will discuss about the very important topic in coordination chemistry, EAN rule. EAN rule simply nothing but it is a stability of carbon or stability of coordination compounds. Now start the EAN rule. EAN rule is a proposed by Sidgwick. This is also called as Sidgwick EAN rule. Sidgwick EAN rule. In 1927, Sidgwick proposed this theory. This theory is nature of the bonding and stability of coordination complexes. This theory is nature of bonding and stability. Stability of complexes. This theory, the metal and ligand bonded. Metal and ligand. Metal act as a central atom. And ligand act as a electron donor. Ligand act as a electron donor. Therefore, metal is also called as electron acceptor, and ligand is also called as electron donor. Now you will discuss about the bond formation of metal and ligand is given by metal ligand bond formation. In 1927, Sidgwick was proposed this theory. This theory is the nature of bonding and stability of metal complexes, and metal act as a central atom, and ligand act as a electron donor. Now metal is also known as electron acceptor, and ligand is also known as electron donor. The bond formation of metal and ligand is given by the two lone pair of electrons is donated to the metal. This bond formation is also known as coordination covalent bond. Now my topic is EAN rule. Simply nothing but EAN rule is known as the available of electrons in central metal atom is also known as EAN rule. And the available and the metal and ligand, the available of the bond formation of day two bond formation day two bond formation day two bond formation of central metal atom, the available of electrons, the day two bond formation of central metal atom, available of electrons around the metal. Ante metal chuttu unnam number of electrons formation to the day 2 bond. Ante enti ippudu metal oxidation state kanna ekkuva electrons anevi aa metal atom chuttu unte danna bond formation ante antaru ante day 2 bond formation ani antaru. Now discussing about the EAN rule. Simply nothing but EAN rule is the bond formation, the available of electrons around the metal in coordination complexes is also known as EAN rule. Therefore, the formula of EAN rule is equal to EAN rule is equal to number of electrons in metal plus number of electrons of ligand. Simply nothing but EAN rule is equal to number of electrons in metal is equal to Z minus oxidation state plus 2 into ligand. Simply nothing but EAN rule is atomic number minus oxidation state plus number of electrons donated to the ligand in metal complexes. Number of electron donated ligand in central metal atom. Central metal atom. This is called as EAN rule. For example, Fe(CO5) and cobalt(CO4), vanadium(CO6). Now start the EAN rule for FeCO5. Therefore, EAN rule is equal to atomic number, ferrous యొక్క అటామిక్ నెంబర్ మనకు తెలియాలంటే ఏం చేయాలంటే డి బ్లాక్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ తెలుసుకోవాలి. డి బ్లాక్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఏంటంటే స్కాండియం, టైటానియం, వెనీడియం, క్రోమియం, మ్యాంగనీస్, ఫెర్రస్, కోబాల్ట్, నికెల్, కాపర్, జింక్. ఎఫ్ అటామిక్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఫెర్రస్ ఈస్ స్కాండియం 21, టైటానియం 22, వెనీడియం 23, క్రోమియం 24, మ్యాంగనీస్ 25, ఫెర్రస్ 26, కోబాల్ట్ 28, నికెల్ 29, 28 నికెల్, కాపర్ 29, జింక్ 30. ఎఫెక్టివ్ అటామిక్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఫెర్రస్ ఈస్ 26 minus oxidation state of coordination complex. Oxidation state of coordination complex FeCO5. Cobalt యొక్క ferrous యొక్క oxidation state ఎంత అవుతుందంటే 0 plus 2 into number of ligands. Each ligand donated to the 2 electrons. And the number of electrons donated to the ligand in central metal atom ఎంత అవుతుందంటే 2 into ligand. అంటే ఎన్ని ligands ఉన్నాయి ఇక్కడ? 5. And you know 26, 2 into 5 plus 10 is equal to 36. 36 is the nearest inert gas elements. 36 is the krypton. Krypton is a stable and it is a inert gas element. Net gas element. This is the all about EAN rule. This is many application to the carbonyl compounds and polycarbonyl compounds of ligands. EAN rule for carbonyl compounds. Carbonyl compounds is different types. Polycarbonyl compounds and mononucleus carbonyl compounds and polynucleus carbonyl compounds.